They are different teams in different sports and separated by 3,000 miles. But Liverpool FC and the Boston Red Sox have an awful lot in common.
The mood of each city sort of depends on the performance of Liverpool Football Club and the Boston Red Sox. We have grandparents, grandchildren, moms, dads. We're a real family sport. As close to a religion as you can find.
And they're owned by the same people, the Fenway Sports Group. In 2002, John Henry and Tom Werner bought the Red Sox, and within 2 years they delivered the team's first World Series since 1918. Having bought Liverpool in 2010, they're now trying to revive another once proud franchise. The Reds used to be a dominant force in England and in Europe too, but their last league title came 22 years ago. Fenway's chairman admits that it's been hard work so far.
We acquired Liverpool at a time of great instability, and it's been challenging because it's a bit like turning around a battleship, but we have a great new manager in Brendan Rodgers, and we are seeing some uplift in commercial revenue, so we're very positive about what's going on.
Recently, Fenway Park was converted into a football pitch for one of Liverpool's pre-season games. That night, Boston were on the road, losing their 13th game of the month. The Red Sox are in danger now of missing out on the playoffs for a second consecutive season, and some fans think that Liverpool are becoming an unwelcome distraction.
I'm not, like, the biggest fan of our ownership group. I think they kind of are sucking money out of the fans.
They won the World Series, and then they bought Liverpool, and look what the team's been doing since that happened.
They brought you two World Series titles. Do I have to remind you of how long you had to wait?
That is true. That is true. You're right. Touché.
The owners have heard the argument before, but stress they are equally committed to both teams, citing payrolls that are among the highest in each team's respective league.
They really do operate independently. People need to understand that there are plenty of resources for the Red Sox, plenty of resources for Liverpool. It's just up to us to spend those resources wisely.
We're better owners in Liverpool because of our experience with the Red Sox, and we're better owners of the Red Sox because of our experience in Liverpool.
The Liverpool fans I spoke with are very supportive of the ownership, and so too were some of the Red Sox faithful. And although the supporters may not feel as though they have much in common with each other, the playing staff do.
It's obviously a unique situation. You've got two clubs at the top of level of their game, you know, iconic clubs in their own individual sport, and both clubs are owned by the same owners. So certainly for me it's a benefit, because like I say, I can get some expertise from other areas, which is important when you're a manager. It's always important that you can learn.
Every day is a learning experience for the Fenway Sports Group, and unless both teams are winning, it's a stressful experience too. Perhaps even more than the fans, they want winners both on the pitch and on the ballpark. Don Riddell, CNN.